Hi everyone, so today we're going to go on a garden tour and we are going to pick some tomatoes. It is that time of year. We didn't do that good tomatoes this year. We had a heat wave come in March. We always start our seedlings in January and then we plant them in March, and then right after we planted them we got a really bad heat wave come through here. So they didn't set as many tomatoes as they normally do, because you usually see them hanging way at the bottom, and they were like, I don't know, 2-3 feet up the plant. So that tells me the blossoms dropped early in the season. But we still have a lot of tomatoes, so we're gonna go ahead and get all them planted. I'm gonna show you some of the garden and the trees and the chickens and the turkeys and the ducks. And my daughter's a biologist, so there's a lot of animals over there at any time. You never know what's gonna be over there. So we're gonna go ahead and take a tour. Let's go. Well, today we're picking tomatoes. Bring down burlap and we're going to do some picking. We have a whole lot of tomatoes here. One end to the other. So, come along and let's pick some tomatoes. Okay, so down here we have green giant. These are Dr. Wench's yellow. Over here we've got Golden Queen. This is Kentucky Beefsteak. Seem to do very well. And these are pineapple. This is a Lucid Gem. Tiger Cherry Roma. So pretty. These are Brennison Art Colors. They don't seem to be doing very well this year. But this is a new one we tried. There's some Italian Aromas. These are Sunrise Bumblebees. These are Siberia. The Siberians usually do really well. More Siberians. There we go. Let's go to the next bed. These are nice and big. These are pineapples. These are really good. We do these every year. We love these. Let's see how big they are. They're nice and big. Get some more in there. They're ripe and ready to go. Over here, we've got Kentucky Beefsteaks. Really seem to do very well. I thought we'd give them a try. Golden Queen. That one seems kind of sad too. I'm not very happy with that one. Dr. Wench's Yellow. And of course this is one of our favorites, Dad's Sunset. Doesn't seem to be doing very well. It got hot really quick this year. On this side of the bed, we got Lucid Gem. Got a few in there. That early heat wave really just didn't help these guys. Tiger Cherry Romas. do very well either. Tried some new ones this year. Really not happy with some of these. These are sunrise bumblebees. Not quite ripe yet. Oh, there's some right there that are ready to go. Some more sunrise bumblebees. These are really sweet. They're a really good tomato. And this is Golden King of Siberia. Golden King of Siberia. But normally we have a lot of tomatoes on the bottom. And we don't have very many this year, which tells me they got too hot and they didn't pollinate. Let's get to picking. Okay, on the trellis we got cucumbers and melons.
See how big the apples?
Look at all the apples. Got a lot of apples in the apple tree this year. These are persimmons. They'll be coming in this fall. Down here we got carrots, and we have a bed of watermelon and pumpkins. Pretty much anything that grows on the ground is in this bed, along with some more carrots. And down here we have catnip, which the bees love. There are bees all over it, and it really brings in the happy little bugs to pollinate. This is the bay laurel tree. Our bay leaves. This is a pretty new tree. Definitely needs some feeding. In this bed, the whole bed is potatoes and onions. The onions pretty much are getting out of there. They're ready to go. It's all bulb. The rest are potatoes, all different kinds of potatoes. This is amaranth. The ducks love amaranths. So here's today's pick. Got all different varieties. We got two flats of tomatoes. I don't know how many pounds is in there. There's quite a bit though. I take this home and make some marinara. Take the steak tomatoes out for sandwiches and stuff. Cherry tomatoes for making salads. You can see we got some beautiful tomatoes in here. Nice close-up of all the different varieties. These are all heirloom tomatoes. There's no hybrids in here. They grow great in the desert heat. Here's the fig tree. Oh, it's gloriness. Over here we got blueberries and fluots. Those are fluots. Over here's the peach tree. It's about done. And over here is the pomegranate tree. These will be coming in this fall. Really excited. There you go. This is the pistachio. And those are blueberries here.
Cherries.
Both
those back ones are cherries.
That's the peach tree. That peach tree is only 4 years old. And it is how tall? It's like two stories tall.
It's one story tall.
Over one story. It's taller than your roof. And there's all the rest of fruit trees. Over here we got the grapes. They're growing up the walkway up to the front door. There's a whole lot of grapes in there. They will eventually be trellised over the top of the walkway.
girls. This is what runner ducks do. They run. Hey, girls. Oh, you're so handsome. The baby cheeks are getting big. My little one. Oh my goodness, look at all those feathers. Oh, look at that.
Well, I hope you enjoyed today's garden tour. It's about 115. It's pretty hot out here. So we do have misters for the chickens and the turkeys, so they're nice and cool. And we put big blocks of ice underneath the chicken coop for them to stay cool. We're in the process of putting in a pond for them, the ducks, so that they'll go into the chicken coop also. But right now we're just afraid that the ducks might fall in, so you know, they don't have any wings to get out, so we just keep them running around the yard and they take care of all the bugs. So I hope you enjoyed the tour. Make sure you like, subscribe, and share. That keeps me going. We got a lot more videos to do. So have a great day and enjoy. Bye.